So when I'm open the hole, as I always emphasize, you don't want to lose your center when you're opening the hole. So when you are drilling it in, make sure that wall has been compressed. So I have my thumb here and hold it to compress the wall. I always use my fingers to drill all the way down to the bottom, to the right thickness. I would say about 3/8 of an inch, a little bit less than half of an inch thick. And then I gradually move my finger to the side so my floor. The floor will be flat, and it also will be compressed. So the floor is opened, and then this method of opening is very wide opening, so that you will be able to use both fingers to both hands to compress the inside floor. And then since I'm going to make it taller, so I usually will color in to get my cylinder narrow. And since the clay is still quite thick, the wall is still quite thick here, so my initial lifting will be just using my right hand holding on the outside, and my inside hand is going to do the lifting. And you don't want your top too heavy, so you know, make sure that it's thin, a little bit thinner. Again, after I squeeze my clay pull from lift from inside, I still want to keep my cylinder narrow. So I keep on digging the clay from the bottom corner using my fingers. So the bottom will be narrow. So my cylinder is getting tall, so I am standing up. So before I brush my sodium silicate, I would like to clean up the base. Sodium silicate and brush over the surface. I leave about an inch and a half here down below so that later on I have a room to close the tap. Now I'm ready to dry the surface. Usually you want to dry the surface so when the shining goes away, that's when you stop. You don't overdrive it. Okay, so the surface feels dry. I don't see any shiny anyway. So now is the time to stretch. You could put a piece of sponge to lubricate inside, and use the sponge to stretch too, if you like. And then I go back to stretch and see which spot needs to come out a little bit more, and I will apply more pressure there. So I'm going to make a gallery for the lid to sit on top of it. And I'm using this wooden rib. There's a 90 degrees there. And get my finger inside and support it underneath while I'm squeezing it. So this is the body of the jar, and I need to measure. I'm making the lid for the jar that I just made. Base motor. So this is where my knob is gonna be. So the knob is smaller, so I make the base a little bit smaller. And then I'm just making like a shallow bowl. With the rim a bit thicker, so later on I will be able to make the gallery. A bit thicker here. let's double check. And use finger to compress this part. And again, use the 90 degrees of the wooden rib. Oh, it is a little bit too wide, so I could trim. So this is the lid that is upside down, so later on I would trim the knob. Just to make sure that this, the width, is fitting in the jar. So I usually make it a little bit bigger, so I could always trim it so it will fit perfectly.